Hi, this is Rich Media Design Productions again, and welcome to our next video. And I thought I might touch a little bit on banners again, because last time I did some videos, there were some things that I left out, and I thought maybe I might touch on those things right now. And I'm sure there's a lot of other discussions about what can be done with banners, but I think that I can touch on a few this time, and hopefully kind of help you mold your banners to its their best possible light. I'm calling this one banner ads or banner ad best practices, and well, I'm not going to be able to touch on everything. I'm going to touch on a few things, and so I hope that if you stay with me and my videos, we'll get to the subject. And of course, you can always recommend something that you'd like to know about, and if I could, I will make a video on it. Okay, I'm going to select an ad that I previously worked on, and this touches on the subject of sizes. I understand that you know, there's standardizing of these sizes for the internet that is taking place by the Internet Advertising Bureau, or IAB, and they're trying to standardize the sizes so that when you know, when you talk about a square size, there's going to be standards that you're going to be having to abide by, or you know, work through or work with. And and if you go to their website, I'm sure you'll find the sizes that they're trying to standardize for the web. Right now, you know, any square size is just about what you can do on the web. For example, you can do a 10 by 10 pixel ad, or you know, it. I can see why there's a reason for this requirement for the IAB to try to standardize, because I mean, you can get to ridiculous sizes and it just, you know, doesn't come make up for a you know, helping your ad in its best possible light. So I'm going to talk a little bit about this ad, and I think this ad kind of brings to a point that first of all, there's only a few elements in here that most ads have. You know, we're not going to make this a animated GIF ad or an animated ad. We're going to have this as just, you know, simple, you know, stagnant ad. That's a bad word to be used, but actually, it doesn't animate, so it doesn't work that way. This is just going to be a regular ad on your website. But going back to what I was saying, there's three, you know, several elements that I said three, but there's actually more than three elements that is required in an ad. And if you can just get those like kind of ready, you know, you'll have the start of a good ad. Number one, we'll talk about it, is a background. Okay, the background is either not going to be there because you're not going to use a background. It's going to be white, or it's going to be a color. But in my case, I decided to have this this design, and actually I had it made. I made it so that I can use it for this ad, only because it kind of lends itself to that whole, you know, feel of the cupcakes and, you know, and the colors and things like that. So this is what I came up with. Then I decided that I was going to have to gradate it, so I made if you look on the layer side, I gradated it from, you know, from almost completely white to the bottom. And the reason for that was because, you know, I wanted the top part to be a lot more visible than anything else. And I thought that the cupcake that I add to this ad was a really cool cupcake. The only thing I did was add a drop shadow in the layer style section, if you can see here, and it's like 1424 and it's at 120 degrees, so, and it's 75% opacity, and it's on the blend mode of multiply. So that's that about the cupcake image. Then is the came the name of the business. Now this could very well have been a logo. This could be a logo. I actually didn't make it into a logo, but and the script itself can actually be interpreted as a logo. So I thought that was a way to approach this. Get it to the right size, have it legible, and we're off to a good start. Now the point of this particular banner was to get them to go to a site, and that site would give them more information about, you know, it would actually be like their website, or maybe even another ad that, you know, that they had that would talk about their business or their particular sales or whatever it might be. So with that, I created a button, and the button has effects to it, and I can go over them real quick with you. There's an inner shadow, and that inner shadow is basically this part up here and down here, okay? And it's at 90, the distance is 46, and then the size is, the choke is 25, 96 is the size. Okay, then we'll move on to the multiply, I'm sorry, the inner glow. Now, I chose this color because it seemed to kind of like make it a little stronger. And that's also in here, okay? That's also, you could see that kind of working in there, that little bit of green. It's about 33 pixels wide, so it gives a more of an emphasis to the edge. Okay, the bevel emboss is smooth, and it's 46 and softened by 60. The color is black, and it has a screen here. So we have a contour, and that contour is anti-aliased. And it has this contour, this shape. It causes this kind of button to occur. Then we have another contour with the color as an overlay, and that helps the button to kind of materialize. And if you can see on the preview, it kind of gives you an idea of what it could look like, and that helps kind of beforehand what, you know, what you want to strive for. So this button was actually kind of worked and try to, you know, to try to get this look. Okay, and last was the color overlay to kind of emphasize the color of the button. And then lastly, what was going to be said, and that was going to be put over the button, that if you click on this area, or basically you can have the whole ad active, so that when you click anywhere in the ad, and I would recommend that, because a lot of people don't want to just go to a particular place in an ad. They want to be able to click the whole ad and go directly. They don't want to waste any time. And another thing to be said about ads like this is, like, make it simple. Say what you want to say right away. Get them where you want them to go with the simplest and the easiest things said to do that. Okay. So we're going to move on from the square, and we're going to move to a landscape shape. And this shape is basically, you know, a rectangle, and it contains the same elements as the square did, except instead of it having a round button, we made it a square button. And the way I got the square is I went over to the tools on the left-hand side here, and you can see there's a rectangular tool, and you could set the radius of the edges to be whatever you want. In this case, it was 15 pixels, so it worked out perfect. It looks like a nice button without being too much of a rounded corner. And I use the same effects that I used for the previous button. In fact, if I pull this off of the other banner, you can see the old banner, and these are the original effects that I worked on. I can actually take these effects and pull them into this ad or onto the other ad. I can actually take the the effects, and if I have this shape already selected, I can pull that section here where it says effect. See how it holds on to the effect, and then have it dropped into that particular shape, and it'll be the same parameters that you set on the one with the square. Another thing that happens is that once you set the rectangular style, you'll see it up here. And if you're working, if you haven't moved out of this work and started another job a day later and you had to turn off your computer and come back on, this should still be there. If you didn't save it, it should still be there if you didn't have to turn off your computer. And so basically, if you just went in here and made a button, for example, you'll see that it's going to have the same parameters that you set for the round button. So get rid of this. I don't need it. Throw it in the trash, and we'll move on to the next one. And this is a skyscraper banner, and basically it has the same elements as all of them have, except for the image in the middle. This one, the one lone cupcake, didn't make it. So I if this were a real ad for a real company — this is a fictitious company, by the way — I would have asked the company to allow me or to provide me a nice image of their other cupcakes, and I might even suggest what I'm looking for so that they can have a photographer do it, or I could have it done myself. So this is what I came up with. I found, and I used it in the center. I gave it a little fine edge border using the same color as the title, so that or logo, so that it works together. And it seems to work. And it if you were to see this and the other shape ads at another time and in another place, you would instantly recognize them, and you'll know them because they are recognizable because of their consistency in design elements. So that's basically all I have to say about these things, except that you in doing these things, have all these elements worked out in your, let's say, your head, or at least have these elements already done before you start working on them, so that way you can just start dropping them in, sizing them, kind of working with them, so that you could either resize them down or resize them up, expand, large, make them smaller, so that when you've got all these things together in a folder, you're actually working with a goal of trying to integrate them instead of trying to fish for things as you're going along. I know it's hard to kind of conceive of what I'm trying to say, but it's actually the best way to work with any kind of ad, whether it's an internet ad or an ad in a newspaper or magazine or whatever. It's get your elements together that you're going to work with, Usually if you're working for a company, you're working with the art director, he's going to give you pretty much everything you need. All you got to do is make them fit into that shape, whether it's a skyscraper, you know, vertical ad or a landscape ad or a square. Your job is to get them to fit and make them fit in a way that is pleasing. So with printed material or on the internet, it works the same way. So I'm glad you were able to join me today, and I hope I was able to help you with a sense of, you know, design and getting things ready for a banner ad, and kind of, you know, give you an idea of what kind of shapes you're going to be involved in, and also to introduce you to the IAB, or the Internet Advertising Bureau, and you know, the fact that they're standardizing the ad, so you're going to have, you know, basic shapes or pixel sizes that are, you know, that are going to be used, and after a while you're going to get so used to having these pixel sizes that they're going to say, I want a banner ad at, you know, 187 by 222, if, you know, if that's the standard, and you're going to know exactly what they're talking about. You'll have it in your head. Anyway, thank you again for joining me. We'll see you next time. And like I said, if you have any interest to find out anything, and I can do it for you, drop me a line. Give me a, you know, hey, can we do this? And I will be happy to do it for you. Thank you. Goodbye.